Spills can easily happen. When a spill does happen, there are certain things you need to do. First, you need to make sure you notify everybody in the lab and restrict the access. Anybody that doesn't need to be there should stay away. Then you need to soak up any freestanding liquid right away so it doesn't have a chance to soak in and cause a more difficult problem for cleaning up. So we're putting paper towels down to clean it, soak it up. We're also going to get some paper bag or plastic bags and use them as shoe covers. This is very simple, very effective. You don't want to track the material around, but you definitely don't want to get it on the bottom of your own shoes. So this way, if we do get contamination on the bottom of the shoes, it won't be on the shoes, it'll be on the plastic bag. Then we put all that soaked up liquid and the paper towels into combustible radioactive waste container or plastic bag that we're going to label as combustible radioactive waste later. Take up the absorbent paper that got contaminated and put that in the combustible waste. Continually check your hands to make sure that they're not contaminated. If there is contamination on the gloves, change the gloves, keep working. Outline the spill area. Here we're looking on the floor, finding out where the area of contamination is and marking it off so we know how to work. We're going to clean from the outside towards the inside. So we're going to gather cleaning supplies, paper towels, and a soapy solution like Alkanox. Wet the area down with it. Take a paper towel and clean from the outside in only a small area. Then we'll check that, see if we're getting contamination up, and keep cleaning until no more contamination comes up on the paper towel. We can check that with the meter. And again, frequently check your hands so we don't spread contamination inadvertently. We'll survey the area with the meter slowly again, 2 inches per second. And then we'll check for removable contamination by checking with a wipe. Take a wipe and count that in a liquid scintillation counter, or provide it to somebody with a liquid scintillation counter to count. Here we're checking the areas, again frequently checking gloves. So it's a slow process. You clean a little bit, you verify that stuff is coming up, and you do it again. And then once it's clean, no more material is coming up, then you go to the next area. Here we're looking at the bench top now, doing the same process, cleaning a small area, verifying with the meter whether or not material is coming up. If it's hot, we do it again. It may be that some areas will need a little bit of an abrasive cleaner, like Comet or something, and that's fine too. Wet down a towel and rub over the area, see if we can get anything up that way. Just make sure you take your time. Make sure you do a good job cleaning. And again, frequently check to see if contamination is coming up. If no more contamination comes up, then you go to the next area. Once we think we've got it all cleaned, then we can check with the meter. It may read nothing, or background. Or there may be a hot spot still there that nothing's coming up. So we'll take a wipe and make sure that nothing is coming up by counting it in a liquid scintillation counter. Occasionally you'll have a situation where there'll be fixed contamination in a crack and it won't come up. And we can deal with that. Just let EH&S know what the results are and then we can deal with it. Then you continue to survey the whole spill area. There may be other areas that you didn't realize got contaminated. There may have been a few drops down the front of the cabinets here or on the handle. So you find a new area of contamination, clean it up the same way, and then resurvey. When you're finally done, then your shoe covers and gloves also need to go into the combustible radioactive waste container. And then you need to survey yourself afterwards to make sure you didn't get any contamination on you while you're doing this job. Again, you need to force yourself to go fairly slowly. 2 inches per second is about the fastest you should go. And which that's very difficult to go that slow, especially if you're excited. So force yourself to slow down and then record the results. See, in this case, the background was 30 and found 110. So that's contamination. That's more than twice background. Twice background would be 60. That was the initial readings. Now we're doing final surveys. And if we had a good job, it'll be back down to background. Okay, in this case, 35. That's less than twice background, so now it's cleaned up, and we've documented it.